Jesus code is 123 go fuck yourself.
Obey the NWO. Patriotic slam fight, bright light, feeling pretty sight. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. And I feel fine. 6 o'clock, TV hour, don't get caught in foreign tower, slash and burn, return, listen to yourself churn. Locking in, uniform and book.
Welcome everyone to the Nerd World Order podcast. This is Abel Loza, and joining me, as always, are my co-conspirator CJ.
Hello.
Barker.
Hello.
And Andres.
Hey.
The NWO is where we're trying to take over the world by spreading the weekly pop culture news from across different genres, which include movies, comics, TV shows, or anything that we consider nerd. The Nerd World Order podcast, your greatest in poopertainment since 2017. Alrighty, guys, we're back for the first time ever without four of us. Not for the first time ever, but for the first time since I went solo last week. But it's always more fun to play with other people other than to play with yourself. So
That's what she did.
We are obeying the quarantine laws. Everybody's supposed to stay home. So kind of, how's everybody been doing staying at home for the past couple of days?
I don't think I've been sober in a 196-hour span. So
you're drunk right now?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I got nothing better to do.
As he takes a swig, did you, so what's your situation right now? Are you guys locked out because of all this whole thing or what?
I don't know about CJ, but I mean, they told me not to come back until this whole thing blows over. So I mean, just basically getting paid to watch TV and drink.
Oh, so you're getting paid?
Are they paying him?
Oh yeah.
Oh, hell yeah. That's good.
I'm essential, so I can't, I gotta go to work.
Ooh, look at me, I'm CJ, I'm essential.
I'm essential.
I'm considered essential too.
Me and Abel are essential.
Are you essential, Abel?
They said insurance is essential, so I gotta go.
You're essentially a bitch.
They told me I was essential too.
Andres is working at Menards and
how am I the only non-essential? This is bullshit.
Who cares about you?
Yeah. Just like Life Barker. All right.
You know what? I'm gonna start rioting.
He's going to write the best damn show ever.
All righty. First of all, I want to thank Whitney. He's letting us borrow Zoom, his Zoom account, so we can broadcast, which is fucking dope. That's really cool. So we can, if this works out today, maybe we can do it more in the future and stuff. And so far so good. I think it's recording on all kinds of different ends. So yeah, thanks, Whitney. We appreciate it.
I think we'll be doing
Thank you, Whitney, but we're going to just crash on you in the next segment, so.
Yeah. Oh, did he say anything on Twitter, CJ?
Sure. Let me. I totally know this. I think he said a whole bunch of stuff, probably.
Okay. Thanks for being prepared.
Oh man.
Hey, I haven't doing this on short notice. Clearly, I haven't had.
I told you yesterday.
Shut up, Abel.
Did you, I see, Barker, you have a beer. What are you drinking?
Actually, this is one that, CJ, was talking about the other day. Told me to go to the liquor store and just get him something random, but he's actually drank this all the time. It's, Extra Gold Lager, and what? Apparently he drinks this a lot in, Manhattan, so.
No, I was in, is when I used to get drunk by myself in my basement playing Mass Effect in Junction. I used to drink Extra Gold, and it's like $10 for a 30, and it's delicious.
Ew. Yeah, it was like $14 for a 30 pack, and it's actually really good. I truly.
They sell it in Garden.
Yeah, they sell it in Garden. I got it from Patty's. So.
There was a beer in Manhattan I used to drink when we were really, 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 really broke. It was beer 30. beer 30 sucks.
That's terrible.
Yeah.
Beer 30 is awful.
It is awful, but we did it a couple times because I would rather drink than not drink.
You got to go Extra Gold when you're
I'm just not hearing about Extra Gold, so.
Okay, so Whitney said things all the way back from like a long time ago. How much of this do you want? Because.
Just do the one. Just pick a couple good ones.
Couple good ones. Okay, let's start with this. We need to tighten things up more. We aren't doing enough. Millions are going to die. So off to a good start. Like half of this is pandemic stuff. Okay. Whatever we were prepared for, epidemics is now how we solved the previous one, but then it didn't get big. Everyone got complacent. Basically, we're all boned. CJ, okay, this is probably the best one he's done. CJ actually has the most correct information for once. That's a thing he said. CJ is going to look up Predator on Pornhub, and he'll be on an FBI list. That's true.
How is that not?
Look through my tweets. They did go on. They did go through. CJ just sucks at social media. Yeah, you know what? You're not so great at it.
But it could come back.
Yeah. Okay. You know what? Fair enough. Edit that out.
Yeah.
They show Woody Harrelson's crazy look at the end of Venom 1. His hair was ridiculous. Which, okay, yeah. You know what? I kind of have a beef about that a little bit. It's like, he's playing an outrageous character. Like, why do we need his hair to look good? I don't think it's the point that it looks good.
Are you like, just saying that because it kind of looks like your hair?
No. There's nothing like my hair, actually.
Yeah, they can hear you.
No, that's exactly what his hair looks like, but just red.
Thank you. That's not why, but that's pretty funny. Garden City used to have its own version of the TED Talk called Nerd Talk. Abel knows about that. He talks about comics. I gave like 5 talks about animals. Just pick a new category. I even gave 1 talk about shit literally. Okay, that's pretty funny. If you can talk about literal shit, that's pretty funny. I put more from Whitney. I fucking loved Hanna-Barbera's race cartoon. When I was younger, I watched that shit like an actual sports event. Wacky Racers, that's the name of it. Yes, very good. If I look hard enough, I bet I can find an already made Florida Man movie. Question is whether or not it's a porn. It probably is. I didn't realize that CJ was an ASMR worker. I wasn't, but I could now. I bet I could sell videos online for like people do that, right?
Yeah, I'm telling you, there's ASMR porn.
Yeah, I'm gonna nothing. Anyway,
wait. I guess I'm out of loop. What is ASMR?
It's when people talk like this, and then they put up like, and then they eat chips. It's like,
and then you jerk off to that. Okay.
No, like, I'm sure it's like, oh, I'm giving you a sloppy blowjob, and it's like.
Yep.
No, I don't think CJ can do that. CJ is loud as fuck all the time. Like, he doesn't have, like, a lower volume. It's like 7 all the way to 10, like, all the time.
Somebody, I was in an airplane not that long, okay, pretty long ago, we'll say. But, somebody said they could hear my voice all the way to the front. I was like in the middle.
Yeah, apparently my voice just screams.
I guess.
It's surprising when people say they can't hear you on the show because I'm like, CJ has a low voice that carries.
Whatever. Anyway, Whitney's very upset that we just gave Carnage a maybe on the villain list.
Oh, yeah? Dude, how's that a maybe? Fuck Carnage.
Oh, he's also on my side. Megatron was in the comics first. So we bleeped over Megatron. So you guys are dicks about that.
I don't consider them.
Yeah, because when I think of Megatron, I think of the cartoon and then the movies.
Yeah.
Well, it doesn't matter. The stipulation was whether he's in comics first.
You know what? Whatever. The bracket's fucked anyways, so it's fine.
No, but no. Oh, that's a great point. Me and Abel were going to say no anyway, so who cares?
Yeah.
He continues here. Jonah Jameson is totally a villain. Anything Alex Jones is like the most worst villain of all time because it's too close to reality and spreads stupidity, which is the worst disease of all. It's a pretty bad one. I'm not gonna lie.
I mean, you get a point.
If you included everything that was turned into a comic, you have the entire Star Wars universe. You'd have the Star Trek universe. You'd have the Dresden File novels, which I don't know what that is. Here we go. Damn it, Abel, you fucking noob. Transformers were in the comics first and part of the Marvel Universe. I'm actually going through the original comics right now because I got them on Humble Bumble. Megatron got robbed. I agree. Hashtag Megatron got robbed.
I hope you can see this. I'm doing it as hard as I can.
I can't see you.
It's a jerk-off motion.
Yeah. Nobody cares about Megatron. There's so many more better villains than Megatron.
Starscream's a better villain.
I love that Andres complains about anime that literally gives an anime fact every fucking show he's on, which is absolutely true.
The truth is,
you give an extra little tidbit about the anime you're watching right now. It's pretty funny.
I listened to the episode. He was so heartbroken when Abel's just like, I don't remember the Pokemon movie. He literally was about to break his brotherhood from Abel because
I can't believe how did I remember that movie?
I don't remember it specifically.
Dude, we watched that shit together a lot.
Well, no, definitely have this fight again. That's something we need.
I have
CT.
I don't remember that.
Coming down, Junior
KO. That. Whatever. I fucking hated working IFCP shows. Goddamn Faygo showers. They would have
No. Go back. He did ICP shows.
Yeah.
What does this guy have not? What does he have? Well, hasn't done?
He used to be a roadie. They would have two semis full of diet Faygo. Why is it diet? That makes no sense.
And Juggalo's gotta watch the figure, man.
I was gonna say
Anyway, diet.
The great Malenko doesn't like fatties.
Oh, that makes sense. Oh, okay, that's why. Bobby, by the end of the show. Every fucking show, there was 2 to 3 inches deep of Faygo. That's awesome. That's funny. That's got to be Faygo. That's how they kept in business, right? No one drinks Faygo.
I've never seen Faygo in the store anywhere ever.
That's the only way. That's how they stay afloat is those shows, right?
Yeah, I have seen Faygo once. We were when we were in Illinois. We were going through, and I remember I had listened to an ICP song, and I remember seeing Faygo, and I was like, I really want to buy one because I want to see it, if it actually tastes good. Or if it's
you want to shake it up and spray it on yourself?
Or something. Maybe, throw a hatchet.
A Faygo shower?
Yeah.
I don't know why. I feel like Illinois is teeming with Juggalos. I don't know why I feel that way, but I do.
No, it's more Michigan.
They're from Michigan.
Yeah. I think it's more Michigan people that are...
Illinois, Michigan, it's all the same. It feels like the same.
I feel like Detroit and Chicago are two different cities.
He also asked, isn't 7 inches average? So do what you will with that.
No, the average penis size is 5 inches, I think.
Yeah. Sorry, Big.
He's a little.
All righty. Well, thank you, Whitney, for letting us borrow his Zoom account, and then second, for giving us his 2 cents. He finally caught up, but since I don't have access to it, thank you, CJ, for reading them off.
You're welcome.
All righty.
Probably, I might add.
Let me read them off next time.
Do you have the Twitter?
Well, you can send them to me.
You just go to the Twitter
account. You find the password?
Yeah, I give it to CJ.
Oh, give it to me then.
Okay,
I'll give it to you next time. You can literally just get on your own Twitter and read his replies to us.
Yeah.
How about you stop yelling at me?
Okay, Mr. CTE, coming down.
Alrighty. The reason on this was running late is because he was giving me the he was too busy giving me the anime news for the week.
You told me 5:30. I got here at 5:23.
And but he did give it to me, and here is the Andres Loza Memorial Anime Minute. Castlevania will return for a fourth season, Netflix confirms. Following the amazingly well-received third season that recently dropped on the streaming service, the series follows the same storyline as a video game franchise, with the vampire clan of the Belmonts assembling a rowdy group of hunters in an attempt to take down the vampire king himself, Dracula. With the series following Trevor Belmont, Sifa the sorceress, and Alucard the halfling son of Dracula himself, a fourth season will surely continue the journey of these heroes along with the antagonists that received such big roles in season 3. So there you go. Thank you, Andres.
This is going to be the first time I've seen that, and I'm not going to give you a fact, by the way.
Are you sure?
That shit's getting wild, because bro.
This bit has been a joke, and it's gone way too far.
It's the best joke we have.
I've had people come up to me and be like, hey, like, are you really a big anime fan? And I'm like, are you fucking? They'll listen to the show one time and they'll get that from me.
Well, that's what we're trying to get.
We're trying to get you out there with your anime stuff. Like,
you know, fuck off.
We'll make you a career of it, you know?
Yeah, you're welcome.
Yeah. This is how people get there.
He's so like a huge hipster of anime.
Now that you're trying to hide from everyone.
No, he's like the Tucker Carlson of anime.
Nah, get out of here, Tucker Carlson. Him and his whatever.
I don't like anime.
You're watching one right now.
Oh, I didn't know today was opposite day.
Jesus.
Alrighty, so moving on. This weekend, there really wasn't a, obviously there isn't a lot of news coming out of the world other than.
Why? Why is there not any news? I mean, what's going on?
I don't know. I haven't really heard. I don't have social media, remember? I don't know what's going on.
Oh, that's true, yeah.
Huh?
But I'm an elitist and I don't want to share with any of you.
The news is to wash your hands.
Oh. Yeah.
And then don't scratch your dick and then touch your face.
I think the news is that we weren't doing that before.
Like, that's
the actual news. The news is that we weren't doing that before.
Washing your hands?
Yeah, that's the real news.
Oh, I thought it was scratching your dick and then your face.
Who are the people who weren't washing their hands?
I always wash my hands. Dude, you'd be surprised at the amount of people. Like, anytime I go to a public restroom and I go to pee and I'm washing my hands and you just see the guy take a massive shit, flush, and then just leave the fuck out the bathroom. And I'm like, bro, you literally just touched your asshole. Wash your fucking hands. It's gross.
Yeah, I'm with you.
No, not unless you do like the mummy hand.
What's the mummy hand?
You just take a shitload of like toilet paper. Like, it's almost like it's like a catcher's mitt on your hand and you wipe your ass. And then you like.
Then you're just wasting a bunch of toilet paper. I use two.
If I'm going to a restaurant, that's not my problem. I'm not paying for the toilet paper at a restaurant. Fuck out of here.
I don't use two squares.
Wait, you have a bidet anyway.
I have a bidet now. I'm telling you, man, that squirts right into my ass. It feels so good.
I bet Ava moans every time you use it.
I always end up at bidets and ass touching. And...
Dude, because my life has completely changed since we got that bidet, and that's all I think about.
Yeah, you know what? I don't blame you.
He is at work, like, adjusting insurance claims, and he's just like, man, I really want my bidet right now.
So the only real news
Poll question. You go, you're on a bidet.
The only real news I have is they're actually going to stop Comic Book Day is every Wednesday. That's when new releases are. But Diamond Publications, they are the one. They're the only company that delivers comic books. And they are putting a halt to it for the foreseeable future. And we won't have new comics for a while, so that'll give you time to catch up.
I heard San Diego Comic-Con might actually happen this year.
But it won't happen till like later, June, July, maybe August. And what I'm hoping is so many people like give up their tickets that they put tickets up on resale again so I can go.
And then they said that Black Widow might actually go to streaming if the order has not been lifted yet. So,
they really
said that they'll put it on streaming on Disney Plus if the virus hasn't kind of calmed down yet. So, I wonder if we're still recording.
Probably not.
Am I back?
Yeah, you're back.
I think that Michael just muted.
Yeah, but the mic got muted for somehow. I didn't touch it. That's what she said.
Yeah, that's why we
said it. Whitney says I fixed him. Okay. Oh, he's still in the chat.
Oh, God.
Nice. Okay.
He's lying on me.
So that's a no on ragging on Whitney.
Oh, I fixed myself. You muted yourself. Oh, okay. Yeah, I think so.
What are we talking about?
Oh, no. Yeah, no. Whitney is he's not free game right now because he's helping us out.
When has that ever mattered?
I mean, he's letting us borrow his Zoom.
That means I can't make fun of him? Fuck that.
All right, make fun of him then.
Wait, is Zoom? How much is Zoom?
Yeah, I did it for like 10 minutes already.
Whitney, how much is Zoom?
Hey, Whitney, how much is Zoom? I don't think he can hear us. He put himself on mute. Oh, 150.
That's awesome. Wow, okay, cool.
That's
pretty dope. Anyway, back to what I was talking about with Black Widow and everything. Like I said, like if this hasn't like died down and everything, they're really talking about streaming it to Disney Plus.
That I can't I yeah may, what they might do is actually what they're doing to a lot of the movies now. I'm like I was scrolling through Amazon this you're weekend.
Fast tracking it.
Yeah, and they're selling Birds of Prey and stuff like that for like $20. So I could see that because they're trying to make some money back on Black Widow.
I mean, I would just push it back. If anything, you're gonna make more money in the movies than you are streaming wise.
Yeah. Why weren't you going to watch it on the
list? Dude, Black Widow's such a useless character.
No.
Oh, my God. You shut your filthy fucking mouth.
I died in the Endgame movie. I'm telling you.
Wow.
It was a good farewell. If Hawkeye would have died, I would have been pissed. But
who gives a shit about Hawkeye?
I don't give a shit about Hawkeye.
Gamora is a better character.
But nobody gives a shit about you, so by the additive property, nobody gives a shit about Hawkeye. All right,
fair enough.
You know what the Stone Cold Stunner is? Barker? About to give you one.
Alrighty. CJ or Andres, you guys have any? No, Andres already gave me his news. Do you have any pieces of news, CJ?
No.
I don't blame you. There's absolutely no news out there, so it's fine.
There's nothing, yeah.
Well, they released the new specs on the new Xbox.
Oh, yeah, I saw that.
Actually, I do have a piece of news. So 2K is one of my favorite games ever. Probably the favorite game I've ever played is BioShock, and they're finally making a fourth one. It'll be a while before it's out, like years probably, but I'm excited that they're even doing it. So that's cool.
We should talk more about video games too. Is it wasn't much of a gamer.
I mean, if you guys want to take the lead, I mean, we have all the time for different kinds of topics. So if anybody wants to talk about video games, I know CJ and Liz probably play the most video games out of us. So if you guys ever want to talk about
whatever, video games, it's pretty awesome, actually.
I'm saying next time you get a console, you need to download that new Call of Duty game. It's free, bro, and it's really good.
Isolation. That's a pretty scary game. It's pretty cool.
What game?
Alien Isolation. It's like a direct sequel to the first Alien.
Really?
Yeah, the movie. Yeah, it's kind of cool. I'm not done with it, but it's fun.
Let's check it out.
Ripley's daughter goes and like tries to like find her. It's kind of cool.
Huh.
Yeah.
Back to the whole movie thing. When was Wonder Woman pushed back again?
To August.
Cinema. Yeah. Yeah, and they actually said that it's going to be late August because they think they want to do reshoots on it too. So,
do you still think we can be in a pandemic in August, or more of an epidemic?
CJ, do you know what the difference is?
Pandemic more widespread.
Does anybody know the difference between pandemic and epidemic?
Pandemic is worse, right?
I think pandemic is global. I think an epidemic is just like now. I think.
Pandemic's worse, right? People are going to crucify me if I remember this.
Pandemic. The definition of pandemic is prevalent over a whole country or world. Epidemic is great radio right now.
That's it.
Yeah.
Can you go get me a monster out of the fridge?
Damn it.
A widespread occurrence of an infectious disease in a community at a particular time. So, yeah, a pandemic is bigger because it's global, and epidemic is within a community.
So it's more civil. Is that what it is?
Civil.
No, not civil.
I'm actually liking, like, because I can't use my phone. Whitney is doing it all for me, so thank you, Whitney, for this. Usually I'm the one that looks up all the information shit, so.
If Whitney, you know what? We can do this real time as comments. He says, for console, PC Master Race, CJ is right. I do look up shit. So, in my brain.
I mean, cheers to you, Brittany. Whitney, that's badass.
Did you just say Brittany?
Brittany. Yeah, I was trying to do Brittany and Whitney.
You know, I saw Britney Spears sing live in Vegas one time. She lip synced through the whole thing, though.
It's Whitney, bitch.
It's Whitney,
dude. I just totally found a what's the word I'm looking for? a visual or a little sound bit for shit Whitney says, and I'm just going to take that Britney song and put Whitney.
It's Shitney, bitch.
No, have CJ say Whitney, and then just put it every time. Yeah. So it's Whitney, bitch.
That's fantastic.
No problem, Parker. God damn it. Alrighty. Well, now we're moving on to really, we have nothing else to talk about, and we didn't do one last year, and it's supposed to be an annual tradition to induct somebody into the NWO Hall of Fame, meaning we induct a movie into the Hall of Fame. We didn't do it last year. I don't know why. Just maybe it was a busy year last year, so we didn't do it. So, and just to kind of give you guys a history of the movies we've picked, the two movies I've picked are Scott Pilgrim and Mystery Men. Andres has picked Mean Girls and 12 Angry Jurors.
You should do this every time.
Or 12 Angry Men.
Jurors? The fuck? You've never seen that movie.
Yes, I have seen that movie. CJ picked Predator, predictably. And then this is Barker's first year doing the NWO Hall of Fame. And what we decided to do is throw a little wrinkle in this and pick an animated movie that we all hold very dearly and is an essential part of your either upbringing or an essential part of your entertainment purpose or your entertainment likes. So things like that. So who wants to go first? Who wants to suck the dick of their animated movie first?
Abel, can you repeat all that? We weren't listening.
No, just who wants to go first?
Dustin does.
Andres does.
You want to go first?
CJ does.
Does anybody have a movie?
Yeah.
I mean, I'll go first.
But nobody wants to go first.
You guys are big, giant wieners. Okay. I tried to think about this, and it made me realize that I haven't updated my favorite movies list in like 10 years.
Do you actually physically have a list?
Oh, yeah, sure, for sure. I have a list of everything. Like, I have a list of favorite albums, favorite movies, favorite shows. It's these mental lists that just, it's ever-changing, except the one for movies, weirdly.
No, yesterday, CJ was telling me a story about how he has his favorite movies. Like, he did an alphabet of his favorite movies. It's fucking, like, that's insane. Like, that's,
so he has a favorite. So he has a favorite Q movie?
Yeah, it's
we were just talking about Q, and that's crazy that you brought that up. You know,
The Quick and the Dead. Leonardo DiCaprio and Gene Hackman. That movie's great.
What movie?
The Quick and the Dead.
Does that count? Is that movie?
You ever seen Quick and the Dead?
No.
Oh, God. Oh, it's great. It's it's like Old West dueling, like when they used to the clock would tick and they would shoot each other. It was great.
Quiet Place?
Oh, that could be good. Anyway. A Quiet Place.
DJ, what's your W?
What's your X?
Oh, W was a problem because I couldn't pick between a Waterboy and Wayne's World.
Waterboy.
I think it's got to go Waterboy, yeah. Because that movie is amazing.
But so is what's your next movie?
Probably X2.
X2, that's a good one.
Yeah.
Probably,
I'd say X2. Then.
I would say X2 or X-Men Day, Future Days. Days of Future Past.
I'd probably do Days of Future Past, in my opinion.
It's on Amazon right now. Amazon or Hulu?
All those movies are great, though. I don't think there's a bad one of those. So that's just me.
But does anybody else like not think like he alphabetized like movies by like? That's insane.
It was when I worked at Tyson. I had nothing to do but be in my own head all day. Like
that's scary.
Yeah, I did that for 2 years. It was crazy.
Damn, being in your
dog. But anyway, revisiting our. This animated deal made me realize I haven't updated that list in years because my original answer was Finding Nemo, which I love that movie. But there's an animated movie that's come out since then that has completely overtopped it.
And that's the reason I didn't pick that movie because I know you were going to pick it.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure you're thinking the same thing I am, Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse.
Yeah.
That's hands down the best animated movie of all time. I mean, it's leaps and bounds. The jokes, the crazy visuals, the music that goes along with it, the story, Miles Morales. We've gone on and on about how much we both love that movie. We all love that movie, and it's well deserved. And so I think it's number one. It's my favorite animated. It's the best animated movie of all time. It took what, like 10,000 animators or something like that? Some ridiculous number. Not 10,000, but it was a lot. I think it was like, wasn't it 10,000 hours they spent on it?
Something like that. Something.
Yeah. But it was like 200 animators. Some crazy number.
As fantastic and as amazing as that movie is visually, the best gag in that entire movie is when they throw the bagel at one of the scientists. Yes. And it says his bagel.
He took a bagel. Yeah. Oh my God. That's so funny.
I fucking love that movie. It's on Netflix. Yeah. Andresia hasn't watched it.
What are you doing?
You don't have time. What'd you do today?
You're in quarantine.
Finish it at least? So you've only watched one episode. So what else have you done all day?
Homework.
That's not true.
That's true. Ask mom.
She's telling me. School's canceled.
No, they still have online classes.
Everything is canceled.
Oh, Abel.
Existing is canceled.
Oh.
Hashtag
cancel CJ.
2020.
Nah, I'm fine with it.
I mean, I've been doing that since 1989, so.
I have a lot less responsibility suddenly. That's fine.
Yeah. You guys are like 30 years behind. Like, so.
Do you know how much of my life? You guys know how much of my life has changed since this coronavirus thing?
How much?
Not very much. Like, a little bit.
Like a little bit.
What specifically changed?
I don't get to go hang out with my daughter as much as I want to.
I mean,
because normally I'd be hanging out with her, but she's actually in quarantine. So, other than that, I stay at home all fucking day and play video games. So it's actually not that different for me.
Can I come over?
No.
I did used to go every once in a great while. I'd go to the bar and get drunk, but it's pretty rare. So, and that's pretty much it. And I'd go out to eat a lot, but that's basically it. It's pretty awesome. Dust is the one who's dying of cabin fever.
Weren't you drunk 2 weeks ago?
Yes, it was amazing.
It wasn't amazing that day when you came over, that's for sure.
Yeah, that was true.
No, I loved it.
All right, so CJ picked Into the Spider-Verse. Barker, let's go Andres. What's your animated movie you're inducted into the Hall of Fame?
Sorry. Is it safe to say that that was yours as well?
Yeah, but I didn't pick it because I knew
you were going to do another one. Okay.
Yeah, but that's
just, I just want to reiterate that we both love that movie. Like, it's not.
Yeah,
just
I fucking love that movie.
Yeah.
And Andres is doing the thing that you're doing with Logan, not to watch it in spite, just to spite us. He's doing that with Into the Spider-Verse.
Okay, if you watch it, if he watches Into the Spider-Verse, I'll watch Logan.
Bro.
Oh, dude, done. I'll pay money for that.
No, I'm sorry. He also has to watch Winter Soldier, too. Because what the hell are you doing there?
I don't get two movies. You just get one and one. Pick one.
You haven't watched Winter Soldier? What the fuck is wrong with you?
He has never seen.
When you watch a movie, you have to be committed to it. Like, you gotta be like,
I would say that Andres's are more egregious.
Or else I'm going to sit there and watch The Office again.
Dude, this motherfucker would sit there and watch The Office for the fifth time instead of watching The Winter Soldier.
Yeah, that's what nonsense. The fuck?
I would fucking rather
watch I think I'm having a stroke because he on this show and he has not watched either of those fucking movies?
That's a good question.
First of all, you guys act like those are like top like 50 movies of all time.
It's like it top is. Five!
That's a really
great movie.
Not top
50
of all time.
How can you cry? I cried during The Winter Soldier. I will admit that. That movie is fucking amazing. I don't know how the fuck you have not watched
it. You haven't seen it. How could you possibly make that?
If I have seen it, I just don't like it because you guys have crucified me.
Oh, my.
I wish I could.
Okay, hey, so
the deal's clear. Fine. If I watch Winter Soldier, CJ has to watch Logan.
No. And Spider-Verse.
You have to watch both.
Why did I get two movies?
Because you suck at life.
Because it's more egregious that you haven't seen either one of those.
Dude, exactly.
Fucker's ass.
As soon as Andres, text me. As soon as you're done watching The Winter Soldier and Spider-Verse, and I'll watch Logan.
Wait, can I come over and watch it with you?
Yes.
No. Those are the same. What are you talking about? Whoa.
Can I sleep over?
You know what? Yes, actually.
Can you guys share a toothbrush?
No. Okay.
CJ has a twin bed, so
there's no way CJ has a twin bed.
There's no, dude.
It's a queen. He has two twin beds, and he makes it into like a mega twin.
Is it still that? Is it still that bed you had for Manhattan?
No, I threw that out.
Bro, CJ barely fits in his car, bro. He's not putting my twin bed.
That's true.
Whitney's asking, "Who's the little spoon?" Oh, that the yes. Two biggest guys on the podcast. I would have to be. It visually, it'd be funnier to see CJ's a little spoon.
Like, yeah. He's just like a little backpack on CJ, like.
No, we've asked that poll question before. Who's the big spoon between me and Abel? It's Abel.
Obviously. Because as a visual gag, it's always funny to see the little big guy as a little spoon.
No. Hold on. I think that Abel's a more generous lover, so he would have to be the bigger spoon.
Yeah, that's fair.
Is CJ a lazy lover or what?
No, fuck
no. Yeah. I just don't think like he embraces people as much as you would.
Shit. CJ's like, I'm done. I'm going to bed.
Get on top again, baby. Yeah. Do you?
All right. With that. No,
right. Hey, hold on. Between Whitney and CJ, who would be the big spoon?
No, Whitney. I like being the little spoon. It's fun.
The little spoon is fun. Don't let anybody tell. Don't let society tell you different. Men, you're absolutely okay to, and allowed to be the little spoon. It's okay.
Dude, it's awesome.
It is awesome.
You just feel cuddly and nice and warm. It's great.
Yeah, it's awesome. It's
okay, there are no downsides. She's mad.
Here, that's it. Will you drop this? It's your crown.
I think throughout the night you have had like a little
thing. Have you seen those on Twitter when Mario's like, here, you drop this, king? Yeah.
It was a king.
Like a two-hour right. Switch, you know? Big spoon, little spoon, two-hour switch.
Alrighty. CJ picked Into the Spider-Verse on this. What's your animated movie that's going to the Hall of Fame this year?
I was mixed up because it can be anything, right?
It can be any animated movie. I was looking at the DC movies. I was looking at all of them.
Because there was two that I was thinking of, and one I didn't think I could use because I thought it had to be like DC or Marvel. Mm-hmm. But I think for me, as an animated movie, I watched this as a little kid, and it always stuck with me forever. It was hard to choose this one because my second choice was going to be Batman Under the Red Hood.
Yeah.
Dude, when I saw that, when you showed me that movie, I was like, okay, that's amazing. And they should make a Batman movie about that. But anyway, that's a different discussion. But to me, it's going to be the very first Toy Story.
Okay.
Watching that when I was 6, 7 years old, you know, just like that, I don't know, just the idea of like toys, like just having that type of like coming to life and like wanting to be played with. And I don't know, it's just, I kind of like that idea.
And
kind of creepy,
yeah.
When you think about it, but I like the idea.
And not only that, but it kick started the whole Pixar thing. Yeah. So yeah, it's definitely a very monumental movie for sure. Yeah.
And I feel like it'd be in a lot of other people's Hall of Fame.
Yeah, that movie came out. Can you believe that movie came out in 1995?
I wasn't even born.
Yeah, you were born in 96.
I was born in 96. Yeah. All you old heads were alive though. You.
Who's it? If he fucking picks an anime, holy fuck, okay? He didn't pick an anime, that's funny.
That would have, you should have, that would have been really funny.
Yeah. That's good. There, yeah, if he picked like Akira or something like that, dude, I would have fucking lost it.
Like, he was going like up, like Batman, Red Hood, and I was like, all right, and then Toy Story.
Oh, what do you mean? Toy Story's awesome.
Yeah, I saw Barker's
face. No, I'm just saying like, don't get me wrong, Toy Story's a great movie. I was just like, man, Andres is like getting into like my good circle and everything that, and then he's like Toy Story. I was like,
wow, wasn't he just fucking talking shit on Toy Story the other day?
Yeah,
Toy Story, the first Toy Story is among my favorite movies.
Yeah.
It's the second one. It's not as good to me.
You're not as good to me.
I mean, yeah.
Toy Story.
Alrighty, so that was two.
Epitome of Pixar movies.
Barker, what is your your first ever NWO induction?
Last ever too.
Wow. I feel bad if he catches the Rona and he dies.
But he is old as fuck. So.
No, this is not my first Hall of Fame.
Yeah, it is.
Is that ages?
Your first movie Hall of Fame. It is
a movie Hall of Fame. Okay.
Yeah.
So, when I got your text, I kind of thought about it, kind of contemplated, and man, it's like picking your favorite kid. You can't, like, they're all great, but in the end, you have to kind of push towards one. So
everyone has a favorite kid.
My top three were Under the Red Hood, Justice League Doom, and the Spider-Verse. And I had to finally pick the Spider-Verse. The other two movies were amazing. Great storyline.
Already in the Hall of Fame. Already picked it.
Why can't I pick it?
Because it's already in there. You don't elect Tom Brady into the Hall of Fame twice.
Well, I didn't know that you were going to pick Spider-Verse.
So pick one of your other ones.
Fine. Doom. And then, like, you see superheroes at their weakest. And, you know, you see Superman and how he's, like, almost invincible. But then you know that, like, he still can be defeated. He still can lose, you know, everybody. And Batman has been through all this. He has this contingency plan. He has planned this for fucking years. And it's ridiculous how there's ways to immobilize, kill these gods, if I say. And the animation behind it's amazing. I love how they brought in different villains. It's not Joker. It's not Lex Luthor and everything that, you know, it's different B-level kind of villains and everything. So my Hall of Fame would have to be Justice League Doom.
That is my favorite part of that movie is that, yeah, it's a bunch of, like, B-level villains. Well, I wouldn't consider Bane a B-villain, but everybody else, like Cheetah.
But he's not Joker. He's not Penguin. He's kind of lower down.
He's bigger than Penguin physically, or literally and figuratively.
He probably was B-list until Dark Knight Rises, I bet. I feel like.
I don't think so. I think when he broke Batman's bat.
In the old movies, he was just Poison Ivy's lackey. Like, he wasn't his own villain.
No, you're thinking of, like, the George Clooney. That doesn't count.
Well, yeah, but that's how he was in the public consciousness. Like, that's Bane.
But, I mean, you think Batman villains, you think villain. Riddler, Joker, Penguin, you know, and then everybody else kind of.
I think now you think Bane.
You could honestly argue that Bane could be a bigger nemesis than the Joker.
He's not a
B list. He's like an A minus list, you know.
No, I don't think so.
I think he's an A plus. I think the only villain above him is Joker. Honestly,
I kind of agree. Yeah. I think he's A-list now. He wasn't before Dark Knight Rises, I don't think, but he is now.
No, even.
I think one of the best parts in that movie is the end when, like, Batman just fucking mic drops the whole thing, you know? And Superman's just like, you have all these contingencies and everything that, what's your contingency? And he just death stares him in the face. He goes, the Justice League. And he just fucking leaves. I was like, dude, that's like the most boss movie you could ever do.
That's a great movie.
It is. It's a really great movie, you know? Like I said, like, it was hard for me to pick between those three.
Is it on DC streaming app right now? No, it's not. I know it was on Netflix for a while. So.
It shows you how much of a badass Batman is.
It's still on Netflix, if I remember right. I saw it the other day.
So. I might watch it tonight, then.
You don't fuck with Batman, basically.
No, you don't
fuck with Batman. He is the greatest superhero ever.
This is true.
Let no one tell you Superman's better.
Barker, answer me this, and CJ, who wins in a fight, Batman, Darth Vader?
Batman.
Yes, fucking thank you. I got into a huge argument with my roommate, and he said that he called me dumb because Darth Vader would easily beat Batman. I was like, no way. Batman's going to find a way to beat Darth Vader.
Yeah, Batman finds a way. That's it. If you gave him like 30 minutes to prepare for Darth Vader, it wouldn't even be close.
Dude, give him 10 minutes.
And if he just does it with no preparation, Darth Vader will put up like a little bit of a fight.
Like, yeah, but in the end, Batman still wins.
Thank you, Batman. Batman wins. Still wins. Thank God,
Batman always wins.
That's how it works.
I love that. That's the argument. Anytime Batman fights anybody in a hypothetical situation,
he finds a way.
It's like he just finds a way. He just does.
Oh, really? I guess there is a video of Batman versus Vader, so I'm gonna have to watch that.
If it's the same people that did Batman versus Wolverine, I'm not interested because they said that Wolverine would beat Batman.
Nonsense. Batman would win.
It's close.
No, because no, it's not. You know why? They had Batman follow Wolverine in like the sewers, and like it turned the fight into an up close fight, and then that's the way Wolverine was able to stab Batman. Batman would be smart enough to not get in close combat with Wolverine like that.
That's obvious.
Versus?
Yeah, versus.
Y'all want to do that? Versus?
I don't know. Batman will always win.
Batman always wins.
Everybody but Batman.
Batman versus everybody. Batman.
Batman wins.
But I'd say Batman versus Wolverine is closer.
Then Batman versus Darth Vader?
Darth Vader is closer. Because Wolverine beats Darth Vader.
No, because like in Wolverine's berserker mode, like he's not really thinking.
I told you how Batman beats that though.
Batman can subdue that.
Batman beats the Force.
How was that?
Batman's gonna throw a batarang at his respiratory system thing, so he's gonna use the Force to breathe, so his system doesn't have to, and that the Force won't be focused on Batman. And after that, it's just a hand on hand combat. Nobody can beat Batman one-on-one.
What if he catches the batarang before?
He won't.
Because what?
Because
everybody catch that? The sound effects, the Batman's battering.
No. It's really great that you guys do not have a camera, because that would have been funnier.
But I'm saying that's how Batman wins. Because once the Force is focused on Vader, after that it's just one-on-one. Batman is an expert in sword fighting. Lightsabers are just swords with lights. That's it.
Works for me.
Yeah. Okay. No, it all pans out.
Batman wins
in this very real situation. It pans out. Your science pans out.
You told me Darth Vader can win a fist fight against Batman. Fuck no. He can barely move against his old ass.
If it's Rogue One Vader, that's different, bro.
Okay, but I'm saying Batman is an expert in sword combat.
If it's Rogue One Batman or Vader, that's different.
Okay, maybe that is.
Yeah.
But fucking Episode 4, he's fucking.
Yeah. If it's Episode 4 Vader, that's
Dare point out the obvious that Darth Vader only has one arm. Like he's not gonna beat Batman. Sorry.
No, he's not.
Darth Vader doesn't beat Batman.
Okay.
That utility belt has so much shit on it, he can beat anybody. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Lastly, it's my movie.
Batman probably has a force suppressor. Like, let's be honest. Like, in his belt.
He probably a spray.
Yeah, it's probably a force suppression spray. Yeah. He has shark repellent. Have you guys ever seen that shit? That
movie? Yeah, he has shark repellent. Yeah, it's a funny gag. I love
it. So funny. He definitely has force suppressant somewhere.
I dig it. Okay, now it's my turn to round this out. I was gonna pick Spider-Verse, but predictably CJ picked it, and I knew that was gonna happen. The second one I was gonna pick actually was Under the Red Hood, but I thought either you or Andres or Barker were going to pick it, and it sounds like you guys almost were, so I didn't, because that's not the one I did the research on. One that I did pick that I wanted to talk about and induct into the Hall of Fame is Batman Mask of the Phantasm.
I knew you were going to do that. I knew it.
I fucking love that movie. I love the animated series growing up, so it was only naturally that I love this movie. I remember buying it like the first day it came out on VHS. Almost wearing the damn thing out. Not only that, but
like CJ Predator,
kind of almost. I wasn't grounded from it or anything, but they introduced a new character, the Phantasm, who was Bruce Wayne's ex-fiance, and it just shows how people can be so very close to almost get married between like these two, yet so far away, and how they both did, they were vigilantes on different spectrums. Like Batman obviously doesn't kill. The Phantasm is a vigilante who wanted to kill the Joker. It's a very, very awesome concept. I think the first of its time. Now they do it all the time, I feel like. And they're actually going, and the only appearance she's ever made is in that movie. But starting sometime, maybe next year, now they pushed it back, she's going to be in the Batman series. So I'm excited for it. And yeah, this movie, obviously everybody loves the animated series. So this movie was supposed to be released on a home release of VHS, but because of the popularity of the animated series, they rushed it to theaters, and it kind of sucked because it didn't do it as well in the box office as it should have. but it still became a cult classic. And when if you bring in all the live action movies and animated movies that Batman's ever been a part of, a lot of people will pick this movie as their favorite Batman movie. So yeah, I love this animated movie.
I haven't seen that one yet. And it's on the DC.
It's not. No, I tried looking for it this morning.
I thought it was. I thought I saw it on the DC app.
It was. I tried looking for it this morning.
Do we all share that?
Look on. I feel like it might be on Netflix.
Me, you, CJ, and just me, you, and CJ. Bark has this one.
CJ, show us your pretty face, bro. Damn.
Are you eating a sandwich right now? Like,
hey, so there's Abel. I respect your choice. I've never seen it, but there's no way you can put it above The Dark Knight. I'm sorry, you shouldn't have said live action.
You should watch it.
I will, but I'm guaranteeing it's not better than The Dark Knight. You should say, with that exception.
Have you watched Logan? Fuck.
I didn't say that. I said a lot of people will pick it as their favorite Batman movie. I didn't say it was better.
Okay, fair enough.
Yeah.
Have you watched Logan?
Lick my butthole. Okay.
I thought you were either going to pick The Dark Knight Rises or The Phantasm. So.
Wait, so I like how you guys, none of you picked the Red Hood because you all thought the other one was going to. That's funny.
I love the Red Hood, but Doom's a little bit better.
Red Hood doesn't get in. I thought the Red Hood was going to get in. I'm stunned right now.
Maybe next year.
That's crazy. That's like we just – Barry Bonds is like – we just Barry Bonds the Red Hood. That's crazy.
Man, it's
– Is it though?
Yeah.
Dude, okay, it's like – okay, no. Red Hood's like Barry Bonds, like you said, and that's everything. Okay. And all these other guys are like, you know, Craig Biggio and – You know,
I guarantee you this. As soon as the decision was made to do animated movies, that's one of the first movies we all went to first.
Yeah, absolutely. I narrowed it down to three, and that was three.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's crazy.
I'm actually 100% surprised that Barker that he picked it over or
that me too. Yeah, me too.
Yeah, that he picked Doom over.
Dude, it was literally. It's Spider-Verse, it was Doom, and it was Red Hood. Like
Doom is fantastic, though.
Like I said, like picking your favorite kid, it's hard.
Not that hard.
No. You only have one. Calm the fuck down.
Jesus' favorite.
You too, Mr. Only Have One.
Yeah, my daughter is my favorite. I have a favorite kid.
So it's not that hard.
Yeah, it's not that hard.
Right. Parker, are you an only kid?
No, I have a half sister and a brother.
And your parents definitely had a favorite. I don't know who it was.
It was me. Definitely had one. Obviously. I mean, you know. Open your eyes.
Yeah. I mean, sure. This.
Boom.
Yeah. All right. Ask your dad who favorite kid is. That's
say me.
See what he says. That'd be funny.
It's like Abel's mom picking their favorite.
She probably has one.
Which is Abel. My mom's favorite is my older brother, Abel.
Wow. That wasn't even like an argument. That wasn't even like a hesitation.
The favorites are usually the babies, actually.
I'm the baby, and they don't give a fuck about me.
Oh.
Well, damn. Baby just don't remember.
This is Freudian kind of getting weird.
Okay, so now that we've done that, I thought the world's on fire. Not everybody's going to be concentrating on this tournament. I already canceled the subscription to the bracket, anyways. So I figured that we can kind of narrow this in a couple rounds real quick.
Kind of killing two birds on stone, kind of thing right there.
How?
Yeah.
The world's on fire, and I don't want to pay for this. So.
Oh yeah. Yeah, no, I guess you're right, yeah. But I figure that here, since we have four, we could probably get a majority and get it down to at least to four, and then that way we can make a vote on it on Facebook and just call it good.
For the record, can we do an asterisk? If Andre complained about anything, I don't want to hear it from him because he was not there. He should have been there. So eat a dick, Andres, if you try to argue.
I wasn't living here at that time.
No, he wasn't here yet.
Doesn't matter.
Took my balls. Hey,
well, do you know how majorities work?
This is the nerd world order.
Are you aware of how majorities work? We have four people. That's not like...
It'll be 3-1.
You can still vote majority with four people. Who are these guys?
Yeah, you can. What I'm saying is mathematically, we're probably in some danger, but whatever. Go ahead.
Okay, so in the TNMT X-Men Marvel region, in the second round, whatever votes we did get, we have Shredder as the number one seed facing off against the X-Men Sentinels, the ninth seed. Who are you guys picking?
How is Shredder a one seed?
Shredder.
Shredder.
Shredder. Are you kidding me?
It's a Shredder. Shredder.
Yeah, only people who've never seen Ninja Turtles would ask that question.
Shredder one seed, but you guys argue about Carnage. What the fuck?
What did I just say about complaining?
Yeah.
I'm not picking Shredder.
So you're picking the Sentinels?
Yeah, the Sentinels.
You've definitely never seen Ninja Turtles then.
Dude, the Sentinels will fucking look at Shredder and burst into flames.
Oh, my God.
It's not true at all. I hate you.
Okay, so before we argue, who are we picking?
Sentinels.
Shredder.
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 Shredder. It's Shredder.
He only picked Shredder so he can win.
There's so many other X-Men villains better than the Sentinels.
No, I like Shredder better. It's not a combat. It's who do you like better?
No. I'm always picked on.
Okay, as a five seed, we have
Juggernaut. No, we're not doing who could beat who, even though I like Shredder's chances. We're doing who we like better. Like who?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
You don't honestly believe that Shredder has a chance to get the Sentinels.
He's a better villain.
Okay, but fine. Sentinels are better.
Okay, no. Andres. Name another Ninja Turtle villain other than Shredder.
Casey Jones.
He's not a villain.
Is that a villain?
No, he's not a villain.
You're disqualified.
Get the from fuck out of here. Fuck out of here. No.
And I was Shredder. Trying to help you. Write it down.
your answer is null and void. I award you no points, and may God have mercy on your soul.
Oh, and then Whitney said in the little chat, he says he'll break the tie if there's a tie. I like that idea, actually.
Dude, I'm going to find Bart and kick his ass.
For sure.
I'm going to give you, like, CTE times two.
All righty.
CTEE.
As the five seed, we have Juggernaut and the four seed, Ultron. Who are we picking?
Ultron.
Ooh, shit.
Wait, I'm sorry. What were the choices?
Ultron.
Juggernaut and Ultron.
You got to go Ultron there.
Yeah, okay. Ultron.
So, CJ, who'd you pick?
Ultron.
Barker?
Ultron.
Andres? Ultron. Okay, so it doesn't matter who I pick.
Yes, we'll pick.
What are you going to pick?
I'm going to pick Juggernaut just to be a contrarian. Okay, so then
that's fantastic.
The sixth seed, we have Killmonger. And as a three seed, we have Apocalypse.
Oh, stuff I really like.
Killmonger.
Apocalypse.
Barker?
Apocalypse.
I'm going Killmonger.
Killmonger?
So that's 2-2. Whitney, you break the tie. What do you say?
You got to go Killmonger there. What are you doing? God damn it.
You're thinking of the movie. Like, you got to go back into the comics,
too. Yeah, of course I'm thinking of the movie.
No, even the anime series.
What do you think of?
The anime series was like Apocalypse, too.
Oh, that's right. So they picked Apocalypse.
All
right, as a 7 seed, we have Mystique, and as a 2 seed, we have Magneto. Where are we going?
Magneto.
Oh, shit.
Magneto.
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 That's a dumb name, though.
Magneto, obviously.
That's a sweep.
Does anybody else think that's a dumb man?
Okay, we're going to go region by region here since we're here. So between Ultron and Shredder, who are we picking?
Shredder.
Ultron.
Shredder.
I'm picking Shredder.
This is lame.
Between Apocalypse and Magneto, who we got?
Magneto.
Apocalypse.
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 Whitney has to break it.
Whitney, you're breaking it.
Apocalypse is terrible. What are you guys even doing?
Not as not in the comic books or even in the animated series. Okay, it's Apocalypse.
Killmonger is still better than even Magneto. I don't know what you guys are, whatever. It doesn't matter.
It's a democracy, baby.
Tom Brady's better than Mahomes.
Shots fired.
Well, that's pretty funny. Shots fired.
All right. Okay, this is going to win the TNMT X-Men Marvel region. Are we going to pick Shredder or Apocalypse?
Apocalypse.
Shredder.
Bro, no fucking way. Okay, fine. Apocalypse.
Apocalypse for me.
Fuck. Apocalypse.
Apocalypse wins.
Yeah. Barely. Barely. Just so you know.
Alrighty. In the Spider-Man Fantastic Four Avengers bracket, we have Thanos versus Mysterio.
Thanos.
We have, Thanos was a 1 seed and Mysterio was an 8 seed. With a 5 seed, we have Venom, and the 4 seed, we have Loki. Who are we picking?
How is Loki above Venom?
Loki.
Venom.
I am picking
Venom.
Venom.
Venom, yeah. Good choice.
Parker? Venom. Okay.
Venom.
The hell is wrong with you people?
What did CJ pick?
He picked Loki.
Of course he did.
Now we have the 6 seed.
Better. Like, by a lot.
We have the 6 seed in the Spider-Man bracket. We have the Green Goblin. And the 3 seed, we have Galactus. Who are we picking?
Galactus.
I don't know how you guys can be so wrong about these things.
Galactus.
I'm picking Galactus.
What are the options?
Galactus and Green Goblin.
They both suck. I don't care. Green Goblin, just to make it interesting.
Galactus.
So Galactus.
I won't argue that. That's fair that you pick Green Goblin.
The 7th seed, we have Kingpin. And the 2 seed, we have Doctor Doom.
Oh, I mean, come on.
Doctor Doom.
Doom.
Okay, the 1 seed Thanos versus the 5 seed Venom. Who we picking?
Venom.
Thanos.
Venom. So Venom wins. Put it in.
Thanos won.
Put it down. Venom won. All right.
We have the 3 seed Galactus versus the 2 seed Doctor Doom. Ooh, Fantastic Four region right there.
Doctor Doom. Stronger than Galactus. By the way.
Contrarian and interesting are not synonyms.
Doom. That's the correct answer.
Doctor Doom.
Okay, wait. What? I'm sorry. I was reading what Whitney said. Shit, Whitney says. Doom.
Oh, so okay. That makes it a clean sweep. Okay, so the winner of the Fantastic Four Spider-Man region will be, and Avengers region will be either Thanos or Doctor Doom. Who are we picking?
That's a good
Thanos. One.
Fuck.
We have one Thanos.
Thanos.
I know you.
We have 2 Thanos.
Fuck, who do I like more?
I like Doctor Doom more.
I love Doctor Doom.
Everybody likes Doom.
I haven't seen him in a good movie yet.
Yeah, and that's Thanos the shitty part. Yeah.
Thanos carried a franchise.
Yeah.
I don't know. He was good in the first Fantastic Four.
That movie was dog shit.
I'm not saying it was a good movie. I'm just saying, like, Doom in that one was pretty good.
Nah, not the guy that played him.
I'm going to pick Dr. Doom because I don't think he deserves to be swept. So
I'm picking Thanos.
Yeah, so 3-1. That's fine. So Thanos is the winner of the Marvel, the Avengers bracket.
If I were to see him in a good movie, I'd pick Dr. Doom. But
he's a good actor. Like, calm down.
The guy who played Dr. Doom sucked.
Okay.
Oh, Christian from Nip/Tuck?
Yeah.
That guy's cool.
Yeah, he's a really good actor.
Okay, in the Batman region.
Record it as best as the movie would let him.
In the Batman region, we have the #1 seed Joker versus the 8 seed Riddler. Who are we picking?
Joker.
#5 seed, we have Mr. Freeze versus 4 seed Ra's al Ghul.
Ra's al Ghul.
Mr. Freeze.
Ra's al Ghul.
Ra's.
Is he more of an anti-hero?
He has his heart in the right place, but he goes about it the wrong way. He's actually Thanos before Thanos.
He was Schwarzenegger with Mr. Freeze. How you guys? What are you guys doing?
Like he wants to cleanse the world.
He wanted to cleanse the world. Mr. Freeze in the animated series. What are you doing?
Yeah,
you know, he was fine.
No, that one was way better than Schwarzenegger.
It was really hard to beat on the Game Boy game.
Dude, all those hacky fucking jokes he did.
Time to chill out. Those are awesome. Those are perfect.
Tonight calls for a freeze.
I think you need to chill.
I feel like if there is somebody that came down and was just like aliens came down and said, like, if there's one thing you could forget about for the rest of your lives, I think we would say the Joel Schumacher vitamins.
No, I like don't Batman. Agree with that at all.
No, I don't think so either. I like Batman Forever.
Me too. No, wait.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, you're alone on that island, Dustin.
I'm not. Whitney. Thank you.
Whitney doesn't count.
Dude, very...
Thank you. Worst.
Wow, dude.
You're the worst forever.
3-point range right there.
Come back, Abel.
Oh, forever. Kind
of. I heard that. Yeah,
thanks, CJ. Alrighty. We got the number 6 seed, Poison Ivy, against her sometimes lover in the comic books, the number 3 seed, Harley Quinn. Who are we picking?
Oh, goodness. I go Poison Ivy, but it's close.
Harley Quinn, close.
Calm down, Lee Corso.
Remember when you dropped the F-bomb?
Yeah.
Fuck that.
Barker.
God,
I guess I'm picking Poison Ivy.
Can I point out real quick? Poison Ivy is like the only person who successfully killed Batman.
I'm picking Poison Ivy.
Oh, she did her.
Yeah, she killed that guy. She did kill. I mean, he wanted her to. It's not the point.
I'm gonna have to go with Harley.
Harley Quinn. Yeah.
Okay, so you're the tiebreaker, Whitney.
Don't break my heart, Whitney.
Don't hurry the fuck up.
Ivy.
Fuck. Fucking.
You let me down.
Why am I down?
He did it just to spite me.
He's just going against everything Andres says. That'd be funny. Okay. we have the 2 seed Bane versus the 7 seed Two-Face. All right. Who are you guys picking?
Andres Bane is like, this guy's winning. Just like, nope, it's not.
Rachel. What is it,
Bane on Two-Face?
Bane versus Two-Face.
Bane.
Yeah, you gotta go Bane there.
Bane.
Yeah, we gotta go Bane.
That's a clean sweep.
Aaron Eckhart was great, though.
No, he was. And in the animated series, he was really good.
Alrighty, so then we have Joker versus Ra's al Ghul.
Joker.
Ra's al Ghul, just because I don't want Ra's al Ghul to be swept. And then we have Poison Ivy, Bane.
Bane.
Ooh.
Bane. Bane.
Bane.
I guess it doesn't matter, huh? Poison Ivy.
Yeah, it doesn't.
The winner of the Batman region will be Joker or Bane. Who we got?
Joker.
I want to go Bane.
I'm going to go Joker. Bane.
The Joker. Fine, baby, the Joker.
Okay, so 2-2, Whitney, you're the tiebreaker.
Please don't fuck this up, please.
Just because.
Ah!
Joker, baby. That's good. Let's get it. Abel does not like the Joker.
It's not that I don't like the Joker.
He doesn't like the Joker. Dude, no Joker, no Batman. Easily.
No, Joe Chill. No Batman.
Fine, whatever.
Okay, in the Justice League Superman Others bracket, we have Darkseid 1 seed versus 8. Who the fuck is that?
I pick Darkseid.
Oh, Doomsday. Darkseid or Doomsday.
You don't even know, like, the guy's name, so, yeah.
What the hell? Yeah.
Probably no, I couldn't see the little picture. So, wait, is it Darkseid or Doomsday?
Darkseid is a Superman
guy? Okay, I picked Doomsday, actually.
Yeah.
What? No, Darkseid.
The bracket is Justice League.
Darkseid.
Darkseid. You would.
The 5 seed.
Well, no, that fight he had in Death of Superman, Doomsday was awesome.
Yeah, boy, that was. Darkseid's like Thanos for DC, like.
Who was the Joker?
And what? He sucks. It doesn't matter. Like,
he's gonna. No, he trolls basically the whole.
Doomsday fought Superman or Doomsday. Doomsday fought Superman. It was awesome.
Does Pokemon like fuse them together? Whatever.
All righty, we have the 5-seed Black Adam versus 4-seed Reverse Flash.
Ooh, that's a cool
one. I'm going Reverse Flash. I'll tell you that right now.
I'm going Black Adam.
Reverse Flash.
I'm going to go Reverse Flash.
Oh, but if it was White Adam, you'd pick him up.
All right, we have number 6, Homelander versus 3, Ozymandias. Who are we picking?
Homelander?
Damn, that's Homelander. Actually a good one. Okay.
Homelander.
Ozymandias from Watchmen.
Oh, that's a good one.
Who'd you pick, CJ?
Homelander.
Barker?
I'm going to go Homelander.
Okay.
Wait, so did Black Adam lose?
Yeah. Okay, so Homelander.
That was pick Abel.
I'll pick Ozymandias so he doesn't get swept. And then we have 7-seed Kneel Before Zod or number 2, Lex Luthor.
I will find him.
I will find him.
Lex Luthor.
General Zod.
Lex Luthor.
Luthor.
Okay, now we have Darkseid, the 1-seed versus 4, Reverse Flash. Who are we going?
Darkseid.
Darkseid.
Reverse Flash.
I'm going Reverse Flash.
What the
fuck? Whitney, you're the tiebreaker. Dark Side or Reverse Flash?
Reverse Flash is fucking dead.
And when he said Joker's overdone, and he said Dark
Side. Dark Side, baby. Ooh.
How are you going to say Joker's overdone and then vote Joker?
Dude, give me Joker all day every day. I'm going to fuck.
And then who we picking? Homelander or Lex Luthor?
Lex Luthor.
Homelander.
Lex Luthor.
Luthor. Luthor.
So now we have Darkseid versus Lex Luthor. Who are we picking?
Lex Luthor.
Darkseid. Who are you picking?
Hmm? Darkseid.
And I picked Darkseid?
Yeah, and he picked
Lex Luthor. All right, so Barker.
Oh man.
Survey says.
All right. Well, Barker thinks Whitney said good villain but overdone. 2 separate qualifiers.
You're a separate qualifier.
You know what? I have to go Darkseid.
Okay.
Really want to go Luthor, but no. Darkseid almost destroyed the Earth. Like.
Okay. So then our final 4 will be Apocalypse versus Thanos on the Marvel side of the bracket versus Joker and Darkseid on the DC side of the bracket. So. We'll go ahead and let CJ get those poll questions out there for you, and we'll go from there.
Yeah.
Alrighty, guys. We're going to get the fuck out of here. I enjoyed this show. It was pretty fun.
I loved it.
Yeah. what is every next week? Actually, WrestleMania is next week, so we might do something wrestling.
WrestleMania.
But what is everybody watching, listening to that they want to recommend to the rest of the order?
I recommended this before. But I was just getting into it, and now I'm fully, like, engrossed in it. The Leftovers is getting just bananas. Like, that show is crazy. I don't even – it gets away with a lot more things than other shows. It's doing things that if other shows did them, it would piss me off. But the way it's done – Damon, the guy who wrote Watchmen, Damon Lindelof.
Lindelof, yeah.
Yeah, he's the showrunner on this. He's the writer. You can tell he has it's like his style. He has a style of writing, and I think I just enjoy him.
I told you that when you first brought it up. I'm like, oh, I think David Lindelof wrote that. You're like, I don't know. I don't think so.
Yeah. No, I believe, I don't know. Either way, he's fantastic. Dude, you can tell he's a genius. Like, you can tell through his writing.
You know that movie that came out, The Hunt? He wrote that too.
The what?
The Hunt?
I don't know what that is.
Well, he wrote it.
Oh, you talking about the one that it's been in the trailers where they're hunting people?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I might watch it now, actually.
Wait, are we talking about the pest?
Regardless of that, this show is fucking bananas. Like, it's crazy, and everyone should be watching it. I'm halfway through the second season, and the first season is kind of a little slower. That's fair. But once you get to the second season, it's a great show. It's awesome. I'm thoroughly enjoying it.
Barker, what's yours?
Well, I guess since I'm the only non-essential on this show and everything, that I've had a lot of time to watch a ton of TV. I think I did this last week, and it's actually getting a lot better. It's getting a lot less campy, but Final Space, like I said, on the TBS app, and you can also get it on Hulu. But it's going from like cartoony to it's actually getting a story behind it. They ripped up in Final Space, and so they're trying to undo it so it's not the end of the universe. Really great cast, really great animation, really great story. So, yeah, if you got the TBS app or Hulu, Final Space, watch it. It's a good watch.
Whitney says he recommends the anime Cop Craft. It's kind of like the movie Bright, and he says he's also non-essential, so
I don't
recommend. Yeah.
You're essential to me, Whitney.
I don't recommend the anime.
Yeah, you do. What are you watching or checking out?
When I'm not wallowing in self-pity for 8 hours now that we're in quarantine. I'm finishing the Harley Quinn show, which is amazing.
Which you brought up already.
Thank you, I brought up. But I'm watching just a lot of random Netflix movies, really. You know what we should watch? Triple Frontier. That movie with Ben Affleck.
Pablo Pascal.
Pedro Pascal and the guy from Star Wars, Poe. What's his name?
What the fuck is his name? Jasmine!
He's Honduran, no?
What guy?
Poe Dameron. What's his real name? Oscar Isaac. No, Oscar Wilde. Yeah, Oscar Isaac.
Yeah, Oscar Isaac.
Yeah, I got it.
Yeah, I'm going to say it's not Oscar Wilde.
Yeah, almost.
Really good movie. And also, I'm reading Absolute Carnage, the comic.
Oh, really?
Nice. Yeah, I wanted to wait till I got the first copy, but I'm just reading that online.
Okay.
So I'm sorry.
Andres, I didn't realize Ben Affleck and those guys were in an anime. That sounds like a really cool anime.
Fuck you.
We gonna D&D over Zoom? That'd be cool. I don't know the rules, but I'd play.
Okay. So I was watching something last night, and they were doing like a D&D episode. Like the 20-side die, like how does that work?
I have like 10 of them, like 10 feet from you. I could show it to you.
Yeah, like do I need to show you? I got like a whole Crown Royal.
Oh, no, okay, so like when you roll it, like the top number, like in like a die, it's a top number, right?
Okay, like, here it is. So like there's 20 numbers on it, and the one on top of the die is the one that's the number.
How is that confusing? In what way is that not?
So no, but I mean like with a... With a normal die, like it's on top, but like with 20, it's like
27, 9 years old. How do you need dice?
Like off to the side or that way, or okay. Everybody, calm down.
You can do 2-sided, 4-sided, 6-sided, 8-sided, 12-sided, and 20-sided. Those are all make even like shapes.
Dustin's lived his entire life not knowing how dice works, guys.
You can also make a 100 die, which I've seen that. That one is hard because it's so small. Which, if you haven't seen that, your penis is too small. Anyway.
I asked a question. I got the answer. Thank you, guys. I appreciate it.
You got beat the hell up. They basically poke you die over die is what they told you. Lord.
Hey, Barker
hashtag die.
He came out of his mute to do that. Like,
let me show you something.
Did you guys see like the vein on Whitney's like forehead? Like when he was talking to me about that, like he was like intense right there. Like, man,
you got mushroom stamp, Barker.
I have too many books. But yeah, if you guys want to do, we talked about it before, and we're not like anybody's fucking doing anything now. So, if you wanted to, we could run through some stuff. You don't need to know the rules. I just need to tell you you're fucked.
That is comforting to know, Winnie. Thank you. Yes. I appreciate that.
I've only had a TV kid.
So for those longtime listeners, that's Whitney. He's, like I said, he's helping us out. And he wanted to tell us – or he wanted to tell Barker how to roll a 20-sided die, so –
No, he just wanted to like face fuck me on like a roll of 20-sided die. Like, okay, for the listeners that are not seeing this on Zoom, he was like quiet for the longest time. And as soon as I answered that, he like was like, "Nope, fuck this!" Like he came on like
you guys in his chair, and
he went off on me. Like,
You're done.
Like I said, you could see like the vein in his like forehead. He's like, "How do you not know this? This is ridiculous. That one's called nerd this is like 101." I was just like, "Wow, damn, okay." I just got
All right,
got Facebook by Whitney.
Well, no, CJ was there too. CJ was like, "What?" And CJ literally has dice next to you, so you can actually like see that there's a one number on top.
He's about to stick that 20-sided die up Barker's ass.
Yes, that's where CJ got quiet. Speaking up, he's coming.
What I recommend is I watched Parasite a few weeks ago, I totally love that movie. And I've always heard that if you're a fan of zombie movies, you need to watch Train to Busan. And that movie is on Netflix right now. And so far, I'm about a quarter of the way through. It's a good zombie movie. Basically, what it is, it's in South Korea, they use a train system a lot more often than we do. And it's basically a zombie outbreak happens.
It's a zombie movie?
Yeah, Train to Busan. It's a South Korean zombie movie. So far, pretty good.
Okay, I didn't realize that. I've heard about it, but... Wait, is Parasite a zombie movie? No, that's just a fucked up social commentary.
Yeah, yeah, it's more about how we need to eat the rich.
When I first heard about Parasite, I thought it was like another human centipede or something like
gross. Okay,
gross like that.
Hey, DJ has a ceiling titty.
A what TV?
A ceiling titty.
That's for when my internet goes out.
Right. It's a type of like common light bulb structure. We call them ceiling titties.
Oh. I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's a TikTok.
It doesn't know what titties look like.
It's a it actually came up as a TikTok. They're like, "Do you have a ceiling titty too? A ceiling titty too?"
Yeah, I know how they feel like. They feel like a big giant bag of sand. Okay, if you guys have any suggestions or comments, let us know on Twitter.
If it feels like sand, they should go to a doctor.
Facebook or Instagram. You can find us personally on Facebook or Twitter. What everybody give their Twitter account?
At CJMFA.
At the Loza 45.
What's up, guys?
At Barker 375.
Whitney, if they want to follow you, where do they go?
Oh, okay. At ZELBUBUTH.
I think it's I just had a hemorrhage in my brain after hearing that.
Yeah.
At @Saint_Abel45. You can find the podcast specifically on Spotify, Google Play, Stitcher, iTunes, Libsyn, anywhere that you guys find your podcast. But go buy some merch.
Wait, hold on. Do not go to YouTube anymore because they're like blocking us. So
what?
Why?
Something about we're taking stuff from King.
It's because of the songs. Something.
Yeah, I was gonna say the songs. If you put any songs on, they're just going to block you right off the bat. They have scanners.
We need our own song.
Yeah. Unless you can prove that you have the copyright to it. I had to do that a couple times with the Zoom, but I did have the copyright.
Yeah, so YouTube is not anymore. So.
All right. I'll figure out. I'll write. You know what? I'll have some time now. I'll write the theme song.
Oh, do you, Mr. Essential?
So you're going to do it now? You're just going to write Essential? A song real fast?
Write a song?
Huh?
Out of nowhere?
You're just gonna write a song real fast. That's what you're gonna do.
Yeah.
We're gonna pay like $10 and just have the rights to
it. Adjusting insurance claims while writing the greatest.
And just bust out a song. Okay.
Cool. Yeah.
Is
that what we're doing now, Abel?
Buy a shirt on T-Merch or T-Public. We appreciate it.
Are you gonna do it on the pot? Like, you just take a shit, just write a song.
Give us a tip at nerdworld2@gmail.com. We would appreciate it. And I think that's it. I really enjoyed this format, so I think we might do it again next week. What do you guys say?
Does anybody tip us?
Yeah.
I guess we're going to have to.
I'm fine with it. I can get, yeah.
All righty. Thanks, guys. Thank you to Whitney for letting us borrow this.
Thank you, Whitney.
Thanks, Whitney.
I'll be IT next time, too.
And thanks, everybody, for listening, commenting, and don't forget, obey the NWO.
Bye.
Obey. Bye.
Oh, that's